Hey kids, who wants to dress up like Big Bird's fugly cousin? I wouldn't be caught dead in this.
Hey, Elamon.
Chloe? What are you doing here?
Whatever you do, don't open the door.
What's going on? Bitch, dosed your tea.
I don't know what you expect me to do. I can't just make money appear out of thin air.
I want my fucking money!
You don't have to hit me, man.
Problem solved. Damn, Chloe Price. What would I do without you?
No.
Mr. Keaton.
No.
Chloe could step in for Juliet.
No fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
I'd say you're super fucked.
Chloe, please. For me. I will not see thee flying forth alone. The envy would be more than I could bear.
Rachel Amber is on drugs.
I'll seek to make thy happiness so great that e'en the name of liberty's forgot. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Hello there, troops. You are here for another episode of Life is Strange Before the Storm Remastered, of course. And you're watching Ace of Space Gaming with your host for today, myself, Thumbs. I hope you watched last week's episode. It was pretty intense, guys. Well, it wasn't as intense. This week's episode might be more intense. But we started last week's episode off with Chloe being in a dream with her dad, and this time it was a bit more creepy than usual, and in my opinion, or in my, I guess, headcanon, I don't know if this is what it was, but this is just what I think, that William was warning Chloe about Rachel, I think, because he talks about fire burning with beauty, and fire being jealous, blinding with beauty, I think, and it being jealous, and I think that was kind of like warning her about Chloe and getting burned. And it was really creepy. And it looked so good in the remaster, by the way. But that's just what I thought. So come and let me know what you thought of it in the comments, troops. And after that, well, Chloe got woken up by the Rachel herself, actually, who very generously brought over some clothes for Chloe to change into. But before that, they had a little therapy session. Rachel became Chloe's therapist, where she got to kind of talk about David and school, and she's exceptionally well adjusted. And Rachel obviously disagrees. But Rachel has some troubles of herself, of her own, because obviously a couple of episodes ago we found out that we saw her dad, Rachel's dad, kissing another woman that wasn't her mum. So he's cheating on her mum by the sounds of it. So Rachel's obviously pretty upset about that, because she just doesn't know if she can trust her dad anymore, which is totally understandable. You know, I'd probably be the same if my dad done that. But then Rachel got called off to go to the play at school, and then Chloe had to meet up with Frank. But before meeting Frank, she saw the lady who was kissing Rachel's dad come out of the van. Shocker! So we needed to find out who she was, and obviously she was going to talk to Frank anyway, so we might as well try to grill him on it. But before grilling him on who the stranger was, we got to meet Pompadour. Yes, that's right, Frank's adorable new puppy, gifted to him by Damon Merrick, apparently. Merrick, whatever you want to pronounce it like. And we got viciously attacked by the tiny killer. He was adorable, by the way. I love Pompadour. But anyway, we had to basically get a book for Frank, and he wants us to go collect some debts, basically. Because Drew North, Mikey's big brother, owes Damon over a grand. And that's quite a lot of money, and Damon is not happy. So Frank wants Chloe to infiltrate and to get into the school, even though she just got expelled a couple of hours ago, previous to that conversation. So she has to try and get her way to school. Frank drops her off at the school, of course, and sorry. We eventually found out that the woman coming out is Frank's van. Her name is Sarah, and she's causing a lot of trouble. What kind of trouble? We don't know, but trouble nonetheless. So hopefully we'll find out more about that at some point, troops. And then Fast forward. Chloe gets dropped off at the school. We have to distract Samuel, but first we had a really strange conversation with Samuel where he was talking about Elliot and Rachel and how Elliot only shows what he wants to show and how Rachel is a dragon in diamonds or something. I don't know. But he also told Chloe that it's okay not to be okay, which was really nice. But we had to steal keys, break into the school, and then Skip ended up infiltrating Chloe's plan by, you know, catching her, try breaking. And obviously Chloe argued her way into the school, into the dormitories to find Drew's dorm, because, well, that's what Chloe does best, is argue. So Chloe gets her way one more time and gets into the school, unfortunately by kind of, you know, embarrassing Skip by mentioning her uterus in fuego. In fuego uterus? I don't know. Cramps. Anyway, troops, let's jump in here. I hope I summarised the last episode well enough for you. There's things I missed out, like talking to Steph and all that, and that photographer guy, I forgot his name. But those weren't... Oh no, well I guess Steph was planning on firing into Rachel, or flirting with Rachel, I guess. So she had to ask Chloe if they were a thing, and I decided to make Chloe say she doesn't know. And Steph offered help, which was really nice of her, of course. But no, that's all the mainly important things out the way. So, trips, can we find Drew's money and get it to Frank and then go see Rachel? Because Rachel wants to see us once we're done. I forgot about that. So, let's jump in here, trips, to find Drew's money and hopefully everything will be okay. So, let's go, trips. Okay, yeah, so I forgot I wanted to go in here.
Could Elliot be lamer if he tried?
This is Elliot's room. I really want to go in here just to kind of see if we can prove how creepy he actually is, you know?
Elliot Hampton's room. Wonder what he's up to right now.
Probably stalking you, man. Like, has he got a Chloe shrine or something? Probably. Einstein. It's behind the Einstein poster.
Elliot does work really hard. I guess I'm happy for him.
Oh, that's nice. I wouldn't be. He's weird. I'm kidding. Oh, what's this?
I've never been able to get Elliot to play for me.
Oh, clarinet.
I guess he's either really good or really bad.
Where's the shrine, man? There's a picture of Chloe. I see it. See?
Wow. I remember this show. Crazy that Elliot would hold on to this picture after so long.
The ears look kinda weird, but that's fine. Okay. He's got a journal. Let's read it.
That's not half bad.
When she left the room, it was electric. Flushed wings taut with agony. This is all about Chloe, right?
Okay. Dark.
I see her in the brick and mortar, in the fresh cut grass. Eyes flashing bright like coins. The ferryman can't have her, I say. But the dark gods laugh. Okay.
Who is it that Elliot's writing about?
I wonder. That moment when the sun is almost there, the sea so welcoming and warm. When pooled lights smooth the nodding waves. When shapeless cold infinity conforms to one stark plane. And for a moment only, all is possible. All say yes. My heart says yes. Her eyes say yes. Creep.
Elliot is way more artistic than I thought.
That's a really nice rocket. They see her, but don't see her. How is that so? When all the world is negative and dark, and she cries out, a screaming rocket, trailing fire. These are all about Chloe.
Wait, are these about me? What the fuck, Elliot?
That got instantly darker. You are about to die. How childish she is, how lovely and how cruel. Her black knife spilling words and dripping ink. Are you talking about my marker?
Told you he was a creep.
What's on your... I'll shut it. Don't leave evidence. That I was here. Okay, what's on your computer, you freak?
Huh. There's way less porn here than I would have thought.
I'm just going to skip the emails and just go right to this because I instantly saw that he was looking up Elliot, but you know, whatever. How to tie a tie video. Elliot Hamden, Arcadia Bay. Chloe Elizabeth Price, Arcadia Bay. Chloe Elizabeth Price. Chloe Price. The Tempest Quotes. The Tempest Tickets Blackwell Academy. Major Lucas Hamden. Illuminati Eye meaning. Did he see the truck? Guards of Hell Book 3. I don't trust Elliot at all, man. I bet he's following her everywhere. Like Molly Foley's Astrid in The Long Dark. I'm sorry we didn't read his emails, but they're really not that important.
The world breaks everyone, and afterward, some are strong at the broken places. Why does that make me sad?
Aw, I'm sorry, Chloe. Is it because you don't feel strong at your broken places? You'll be strong, don't you worry. You got this, Chloe. Anyway, let's go. Let's leave Elliot to it, the big creep that he is. Can't get over that freak. Can we call him a creep on his thing? Yes. Graffiti.
Elliot likes to write poetry about me, eh? What do I want to say in response?
I'm gonna be a poet.
Emotional. Loyal. Introverted. Odd. And talented.
I shouldn't have wrote that. I should have called him a creeper. At least that's one more graffiti thing done. Definitely should have called him a creep, though.
Yep. Definitely Drew's room.
Okay. I guess maybe knock to see if anyone's in here first. No? Okay. Can we find the money? Oh, is Mikey staying here too? Why is there no music?
Drew's not here. Okay. If I were Drew, where would I hide my money?
A multitude of places.
Holy shit, Drew. A college scholarship? No wonder you're so into football.
Dear Drew, it is my great pleasure to award you a full athletic scholarship to play football at Oregon State University. We know that a young man of your skills and character would make a great addition to the OCOSU franchise, a football dynasty that has produced NFL talent for decades. On you go, Drew. What you looking up?
Frank wasn't lying. Looks like Drew sells happy pills to his fellow meatheads.
Oh, this is from someone. Hey, bro, you have any more happy pills? I beat his hair. You saw me take that hit for you last night, right? No one gets on my boy's grill on my watch. But hook me up, will you? Something just to take the edge off is all I need. And that's what they all say, man. Okay. I guess we'll look at Mikey's stuff, too.
Durgeron. Yeah. That fucker's dead.
Is he? Has he? We've all saw true colors wavelengths.
Bad guys don't usually look so obvious, but this is still awesome.
Yeah, it's really cool. Nice! Awesome. A T-Rex. Dr. Tamba, the Jurassic Edition. I wish I could draw like that.
Mikey's figures. Playing that game yesterday was actually fun.
It was really fun. I do love that part of the game.
Looks like Mikey's been staying here with Drew. They look Aww. So happy.
That's so cute. Sticky note?
Oh, Man, looks like Drew's dad is having a hard time.
Oh man, that's not good. How can they stay in school? Is that why he's selling the drugs? That looks like where you'd hate money. But because they've not got much money? That's shaming.
Is the money in there? All right. Guess I have to crack a 4-digit code.
Okay. Maybe I do need to read the... Let's see, is that written on the calendar? But, you know, it kind of makes me feel a bit bad about the whole, you know, I need to steal a grand off them when they're struggling so much, man.
I wonder exactly how important 516 is to Drew.
0516, would it be? 0516?
Damn it. Wrong numbers.
Okay. That's fine. That was just the first try. Wait, I haven't read the journal. Okay, we've got 2 journal pages. I really apologize, but I'll get it all undone at a tick. Just you hang in there, troops. Or you can skip it. Don't worry. I don't mind if you don't care about the diaries. I just like to kind of get them in the way because it gives a wee bit more insight to what's going on in Chloe's heat. Max, ever been to therapy? It's actually kind of awesome. And I don't mean writing down your feelings and hugging and crying and shit. I'm talking about popping open the hood and getting your hands dirty. Rachel's awesome at it, because of course she is. We talked about my mom, David, the fire, my expulsion. Rachel didn't want to talk as much, but I got her to open up. I'm glad I did. By the end, everything, I don't know, seemed a little less broken, I guess. Aww. Speaking of, I found this gnarly truck that I started fixing up. Who knows if I'll ever get it running, but for now, I'm glad just to have a problem I might actually be able to solve. It may be an escape vehicle. Stay tuned. Fixing trucks and fixing brains. Who needs school anyway? Chloe, the less broken fixer. You're also very talented with your drawings. I love them. Alright, on to the next page. No more dilly-dallying. Max, how do you know when it's time to take a relationship to the next level? Oh. I'm talking about my drug dealer, Frank, of course. He wants me to do a job for him, picking up money from Drew North. You know Drew, Blackwell's premier jockstrap, and now, apparently, Oxy dealer? Dude's in pretty deep, it seems. Yeah. But it should be an easy job, and besides, I could use the money for mine and Rachel's escape fund, of course. Which, speaking of Rachel, guess who's... Skeezball Dad's side piece I saw coming out of Frank's RV. I pressed Frank for info and learned that her name is Sarah, and she's only been around for a couple of weeks. Oh, and she loves the drugs. Weird. But what kind of drugs is the main question to that, you know? Alright, off to make my triumphant return to Blackwall. At least I'm getting paid to go there this time. Chloe, the criminally awesome. You are criminally awesome, Chloe. See, I told you we'd be done in 2 texts, guys. We're all done. Sorted.
All right. I didn't realize Drew was
this. We've already heard this.
Frank, so many folks are shit out of luck around here.
Is there no dates on this?
At least Drew has some prospects.
What's this?
Plenty of possible combinations here.
Okay. Okay, so could it be, 0403 for Drew's birthday or 1227 for Mikey's birthday? Oh, we can dish check. I feel like maybe he'd pick his wee brothers over his own date of birth. So we're gonna go 12. Was it 27? I hope it was 27. Is that yes?
Yes! Yes! This is kind of fun.
Yep, breaking and entering. That's hilarious.
Aw. Did little Drew beat you up too?
You don't know what's going on in Drew's life, Chloe.
Jackpot.
Oh, wow.
I'm kind of good at this. Okay, got the money. Time to bust out of here.
Okay, time to get out of here. Okay, let's go. Oh no. Is that Mikey? Oh, it's Mikey. Oh, hi!
Hey, Elamon.
Chloe? What are you doing here?
Nothing. I'm looking for Drew, yeah. To apologize.
I was looking for your brother, but he's not here, so.
Why?
Just cause.
We gotta go. Yesterday wasn't enough?
Oh.
You wanna go another round?
I'm sorry!
Doesn't matter. Mikey, get your stuff. Let's move.
What's wrong? Are you okay?
Drew, relax. Whoa.
Who?
Slow down.
Who is that? Oh, fuck. Why did you send me if you're just gonna show up?
You're making me think you're nervous about something.
What's going on? Yeah.
Drew, what's going on?
Don't worry about it. Stay in here. And don't say anything, little brother. Whatever you do, don't open the door.
Oh, okay.
You know what's going on?
Damon, you shouldn't have come here. School's not the place for this.
Really? Where is the place to collect my fucking money?
Oh. Shit.
I told you, I don't have it. Sales are down, man. Nobody wants to get high right now. But look. It's spring season. We just started two-a-days. Those are gonna kill us. I'll be able to sell all the oxy you've got.
Drew, you owe me a grand. Where is it?
I said I don't have it right now. I heard about your dad's job, by the way.
Oh.
Tough times.
Damon.
Yeah.
Don't be that guy.
Bet a grand would mean a lot to him right now.
Oh, no.
Where's my money, Drew?
Nowhere. It got lost.
I don't know what you expect me to do. I can't just make money appear out of thin air.
I want my fucking money!
You don't have to hit me, man. I'm good.
Where is it?
Please! Just give me one
more.
You're just going to lie there? I thought football players were supposed to be tough.
Mikey, he told us to stay.
Have to do this, kid!
No oh, God!
Steals from me!
He's really getting beat up.
Fuck.
Yeah, fuck.
Fuck.
Oh, God. Ah, do we... if I give... Shit. If I give Damon the money, they'll hate me. But if I stay with Mikey, Drew gets the crap kicked to him. But it's no good for Mikey to see his brother being beaten the shit out of him. I'm gonna stay with Mikey? Yeah. Not a good move.
Let me go!
No. I'm sorry.
Your brother said to stay inside.
You could get hurt too, Mikey.
It'll be okay, Mikey. It'll be okay.
He's a dangerous guy.
Damn, you are one tough kid.
Oh, God.
Fuck you. Yeah? Well, what about this?
Oh!
Good luck running on that knee now.
Oh, fuck.
Bye-bye, football.
Fuck!
Well, I'm done. Get my money. Or maybe it'll be your little brother I talk to next.
Get the fuck, Damon.
See you soon.
Leave Mikey alone. Oh, God, are you okay?
Drew!
It's okay. I'm okay, little brother.
You do not look okay. Oh, God.
Thank you, Chloe. Thank you.
Oh, fuck, did I give him the money? Oh, God, did I give him the money? You know what? I'm actually going to give them the money, because they need it, and I just want Chloe to be nice. We really need that money, though. Oh, I don't know what to do, guys. So what would you do? Come and let me know in the comments what you would do. I'm going to keep the money. I know they need it, but I'm keeping the money. Chloe needs the money to run away with Rachel. Yeah, I'm sorry.
I didn't do anything.
You kept my brother safe.
Drew, you need to get to the hospital.
Yeah.
Don't tell anyone about this, okay?
Yeah. No. No way. What? What are you going to do?
About Damon? I don't know.
Yeah.
One day at a time.
I hear you.
I feel really bad. I should have gave him the money, man. Regrettable choices! I was thinking that Frank is going to be mad if I don't give him the money, though, you know? Everything has a consequence in this game. Oh, yeah! I forgot about this! This is my favorite part of the game. Just saying. I don't know why it's so silent. Sorry. I was gonna be like, is the play tonight? But we know it is, because we've already spoken to Rachel about that. Hayden, you look great. Looks great.
This day has been so messed up. At least I can talk to Rachel now.
Oh.
If I can find her back here.
But Steph messaged. Okay. Chloe, it's Steph. I'm on my way to the hospital. Oh, God. Mickey told me what happened. Poor Drew. I'm still stunned. Thank you for what you did. Stealing their money? I didn't do anything. You held on to Mikey. Oh, he told me. It meant a lot to him. Oh, no. I'm so sorry. No. I feel so bad. I'm so sorry, Mikey, man. Wait, how many graffiti things have I got to do for this episode? Tea. Okay.
I've already seen what happens when Rachel plays with fire. Rachel plus swords should be fun.
Yeah. Oh.
I can play with them.
Chloe Price presents Firewalk. Laser Light Spectacular.
Where's my graffiti delight? I totally try and do the same thing. Let's talk to Mr. Keaton. Hello, Mr. Keaton.
Sup, Mr. Keaton.
Sup.
The birds. The girl. The desire to be free. How romantic.
Tell me, young lady, do you still believe true love exists?
Well, she's been through a lot ever since that one time yesterday, endgame. But I'm gonna say she thinks, yeah.
Sure, I think so. But it's a lot weirder and scarier than poets and pop songs make it out to be.
Aww.
You might be surprised, my dear. Budding dramaturge, may your propitious appearance counteract the tragedy of Stephanie Gingrich's sudden recusal.
Aww.
An emergency, she says.
It is an emergency.
Word.
Stephanie Word. Was our lion of the light board, but platitudinal though it may be, the show must sojourn forth.
Yeah. The show must go on and on.
That dude is weird.
Yeah. But not the bad kind of weird, you know? Dana! I knew her name was Dana.
Did Doug dig David's garden?
What's going on here? Oh, Nathan's back there. 2 seconds. I want to see what Hayden's saying.
Hey, Hayden.
Address me as Ferdinand, good lady.
Go fuck yourself.
All right. Hey, Ferdinand.
Sup, Chloe. sup, fair maiden.
Great method acting.
Yeah.
Really? Thanks.
Hayden, you're some man.
Ooh, boys tent.
Samantha, what are you doing snooping?
Hey, Samantha.
Shh.
Nathan. Please.
Oh. I can't do it, Dad. I'm sorry.
Keep your...
You don't understand. They all hate me. They're just gonna laugh at me.
Props.
Why do you suppose that is?
I don't know.
Because you show weakness. Just like you're doing right now.
But Dad...
When will you learn that this isn't about you and your problems? This is about the Prescott name. My name.
That's why he is the way he is.
You will not embarrass me.
Because he's Dad's tattoo.
Nathan.
Yes.
Good. Now. Break a leg. I'll see you after the show.
Uh-huh. I feel like Chloe would say something. Yeah.
Great pep talk, Mr. P. Everyone knows the best way to instill confidence in someone is by intimidating them.
I don't know who you are, but mind your own business.
I'd love to. Don't you have, a private bunker filled with gold coins where you could have these conversations?
You can give me a look all you want. You're still a dick. You're welcome.
Nathan.
That's twice I've stuck up for you. Prick.
Fuck!
Wow.
Samantha, I honestly don't know why you try. Why do you even bother? I just taught.
Hey.
Wow.
Nathan's dad is... some asshole, huh?
Yeah.
No. I wish he'd just go away and leave him alone.
You should be careful, yeah.
Nathan's dad sucks. But you should be careful what you wish for when it comes to parents.
Oh.
Oh, Chloe.
Oh.
I wasn't thinking.
Didn't even think of that.
I'm sorry.
For what? You didn't kill my dad. Or did you? That was a joke.
I know. Your dark sense of humor reminds me a lot of Nathan's.
Whoa.
Actually, the two of you are really similar.
Oh!
What the hell does that mean?
Yeah.
I'm serious. You're both artistic and surprisingly sensitive. You've been through a lot, and a lot of people unfairly judge you for it. I think you stood up for Nathan yesterday because you know what he's going through.
No.
Nathan's hurt, and he needs help. But whenever I try to help him, it always seems to make things worse.
Because he's a dick.
If you were Nathan right now, what would you want me to do?
Give him up. Yep. Also, I stuck up for Nathan because I wanted better results for my playthrough. I'd give him space, honestly. He's a loose cannon, that one, man.
When I'm super angry, I need to let it all out. The last thing I want is someone trying to calm me down.
Yeah.
Case in point, how pissed he was when we tried to help him yesterday.
Yeah.
If I were you, I'd give him space and wait for him to come to you.
That actually makes sense.
Yeah.
Thanks, Chloe.
You're welcome.
I feel like Samantha looks a bit better. Is that because of the update? Is there a reply?
Bitter much?
I don't get bitter. I get even.
Wonder which Bachelor contestant Victoria stole that line from.
It's actually drag queens. No, I'm kidding. Don't get bitter, just get better. Rachel! How's your super long errand going? Yo, crazy shit happened in Drew's room. Like, really bad. Oh no, are you okay? Do you need to talk about it? Oh. Yeah, Leo, don't worry until the show's over. I'm backstage. Great, on my way. Aw, I love that Rachel's like, oh, do you want to talk about it? Asking if she's okay. Oh, Rachel, you're such a gem. You're a dragon diamond, apparently. Aw. Okay. So, we've just to get her backstage, apparently.
I should find Rachel.
But first, Dana, you got anything to
did
say?
Did Doug dig David's...
Hey, Dana.
Did Doug dig David's garden? Or did David dig Doug's? Did Doug dig David's garden?
Know.
Okay, I think we've done everything I needed to do here. Let us go!
Rachel?
There's an absolutely hilarious part coming up. Honestly, you need to stay tuned for this bad boy. Hi, Victoria Chance. She would have been taking Rachel's place if Rachel was still banned from the play. Chloe, your skin is crazy. What are you doing? Chloe's glowing. Are you spiking the tea, Victoria? Chloe, what the fuck is up with your complexion?
Whatever that was, it was shady as shit.
Yeah.
I need to find whatever Victoria slipped into that drink.
Yes, we do. Frank, what are you wanting? I have heard, though, a lot of people complained quite a bit about this, the remaster, and that there's quite a lot of glitches, so maybe the skin tone and the dirty hands of last week's episode are part of those glitches, I don't know. Oh god, oh fuck. Okay. Whoops. So, I just talked to Damon. He said he had to come down hard. Didn't see you. He didn't. What happened? Did you find the money? Price, where's the money? This is serious. Quit fucking around. Unless you're dead, reply. Let's meet tomorrow. Have answers. Well, shit, boy. This is why I didn't... There's so many consequences to deal with. Anyway, let's go, I guess. Find out what Victoria's been doing. I'm quite sure there's something for me to graffiti. Nice masks.
Hey, kids. Who wants to dress up like Big Bird's fugly cousin?
Whoa!
I wouldn't be caught dead in this.
Big Bird is cool as heck. And no.
Adding putting on makeup to the long list of reasons I wouldn't be caught dead on stage.
Yep. See me or Mr. K for makeup kits. Steph Gingrich. Okay, we'll just search the bag then. I don't know if there's anything to graffiti at the moment.
Only the finest child slave labor for Victoria Chase.
Whoa, I've never heard that line before. What are you hiding, Victoria? Vicky. Pills. Wow. Did they cut out you actually spilling the bag or like emptying the bag? Because I feel like you usually see that, no? Anyway.
Victoria Chase is actually a pretty talented photographer.
Unfortunately.
Why does that piss me off so much?
Because you don't want to like her, that's why. Wow, Drew and Mikey. Interesting. You need people's permission before taking these photos? How the fuck? I've always wanted to know how she took this photo. Do you have a really tall tripod? Is that not the statue in front of the school? Unless there's other statues I don't know about. I don't know, but I've always been confused about that one. That is a good photo. A photo of a photographer taking photos of birds. Artistic. And I do actually like them. I went to college for photography, so I know a little bit about it. Or I can appreciate good photos. But what the hell are these pills?
Muscle relaxers?
Wow. How did she get a hold of them? Can you buy that stuff? From Drew.
Coming, Rachel?
Oh.
Hurry now before your tea gets...
Hi, Rach. Oh, God. Glitches.
What are you doing here?
Glitches!
This area is for cast and crew only.
What's with this?
Or are you only here to try and sabotage the play like you sabotaged my homework? God, you're pathetic.
Oh, I'm the pathetic one, Emma. I am definitely here for Rachel. I also apologize if there's going to be blinky lights off their jewelry. I will put a warning up. And their skin tone's horrible.
But we're gonna roll with the troops. And also, screw you, Victoria Chase.
I'm here to support Rachel.
Of course.
How nice.
Oh, that's...
I want to make sure she's relaxed before the show.
Whatever.
Rach, you need something.
Oh, Rachel Amber. It was customary among the thespians of ancient Greece for the understudy to offer hot tea to the lead actress on opening night.
Uh-huh.
As a way of showing appreciation for her tutelage. It is in that spirit that I offer you this beverage. May it help to reveal the essence of your talents for all to see.
Wow. That, thanks.
Oh, yeah, I'm gonna distract Victoria, because just wait for this, guys, honestly.
Hold up. Did you hear that?
Hear what? I didn't hear anything.
Oh, I hear it now. It sounds like Mr. Keaton's calling for you.
Thanks.
He is? Oh, he probably wants my thoughts on the set dressing. Okay,
yep.
Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
Of course you will.
What's going on?
Bitch, dosed your tea.
Yeah.
That is... the least surprising thing ever. What should we do?
Switch the cups, of course! Yes!
Problem solved.
Yeah, boy.
Damn. Chloe Price. What would I do without you?
Have super relaxed muscles, I guess.
Mr. Keaton's busy with Nathan. I'm sure he'll call on my aesthetic sensibility soon. In the meantime, let us drink.
Yep. Oh, God. Why are you Chloe blinking? You don't have jewelry. Why is, not why are.
Oh, make sure you drink it all. Your instrument will thank you.
So will yours.
I am so grateful to have such a kind and caring friend as you, Victoria.
Aw, yeah. Samesies.
Samesies. Samesies.
Samesies too.
Anyway, I'll see you out there. Break a leg.
You too.
So, that happened?
It did.
Just when I thought this day couldn't get any batshit crazier.
Oh, hey, that's mine.
Yep.
A shirt for a free spirit. I knew you were gonna pick that one.
You
can read me like a script, Rachel Amber.
Sweet Tarnation, we're
yes.
ruined. The show is ruined.
It's coming up.
That was quick.
Yes, it was. Also, they're still
My
adorable.
Dear young artists, a misfortune most unkind has befallen us. Juliet is waylaid.
Oh, yeah.
That infernal inferno is the culprit, closing down the roads and robbing us of our Ariel. Would that she could but manifest on her master's whim as a true spirit. Alas, devoid of an understudy, the situation is a dire one indeed.
Why didn't you have an understudy?
I'm afraid we may have to cancel.
Everybody's here.
Truly, we are a cursed lot. Even my prodigious imagination cannot conceive of a worse turn of fate.
I can.
Mr. Creighton!
Yes.
I have revelations to reveal.
Creighton.
Rachel Amber is on drugs. Look at her. Her face is so blurry and pretty. She's clearly been drugged. I mean, drugged herself. She loves drugs. Don't you?
She's been drugged.
Touché, fates. Touché.
That's honestly one of my favorite parts. She's been
drugged.
Oh, no.
Mr. Keaton.
No.
Chloe could step in for Juliet. No fucking chance.
At least until the road's clear.
The romantic...
She's the right fit for Juliet's costume.
Of course she is.
She is indeed. Tell me, my dear, have you ever acted before?
No.
Hell no. She's being modest. We play improv games all the time. And she's fantastic at it.
My dear, What if I told you that the entire fate of the production rests upon your slender shoulders?
I'd say you're super fucked.
Chloe, please. For me.
Don't pull that kid. That's such a cheap move, Rachel. Exactly.
Damn it.
Oh, yeah. She's in the play, guys.
I can't believe Rachel's talked me into this.
Yeah, I can. You really can't believe that? As if, like, you wouldn't do anything for Rachel at all. Lies. All lies. I knew I could graffiti something, though.
When life gives you lipstick, use it to tag shit.
I'm gonna write tragedy, because Victoria is a tragedy. What did you think of that part, though, guys?
Got it.
Absolutely hilarious, isn't it? Ah, oh, she's been drugged. Anyway, come and let me know what you thought of the drugging of Victoria chasing Rachel. Absolutely brilliant. Nice, one more left to go. Okay, well, there's the script. I'm not going to read it all out to you because then it will ruin the play. You know, we don't want that to happen. Oh, we can smoke some before we go! Yes.
The best part of being kicked out of school is never having to worry about getting kicked out of school.
I mean, I guess that's true. Just spark up whenever you want, wherever you want. Fuck it.
Poor Drew. He was just trying to keep his little brother safe, and there I was, stealing from him.
Yeah.
God, that Damon Merrick guy was such a freak.
He's a douchebag.
It's hard to imagine Frank being mixed up with a guy like that. But then again, I guess I don't really know Frank all that well.
Exactly. He's your pot dealer. There's literally no music in this episode at all. What is that all about? Are we done here? I'm gonna... Nope.
I really hope Drew and Mikey are going to be okay.
Yeah, same.
Well, let us go. We got a play to do, guys. Don't... You're inside a tent?
What do you mean?
Somebody shouts in, like, are you anybody smoking weed in here? Okay, we're gonna read the script, but not fully.
I seriously have to memorize all of this? Thanks, Rachel.
Don't worry, it's totally worth it. Okay, so we are obviously the yellow ones. All hail, great mistress, I come to answer thy best pleasure. I board the king's ship. I'm not going to read them out. You can read them if you want. Feel free to pause and read, but I'm not going to because it's part of the game, you know, part of the play. So I already know what ones to pick. It's fine. I got to go to the next page. So make sure you pause it if you want to read it. I'll do that with the other one, sorry. The first page and then moving on. Remember to pause and read. I'm gonna change a page now. My liberty. That's my noble mistress. And then we exit. Pause and read. If you want to know what happens. Now I'm gone. Let's go. I'm gonna go do the play. Let's go and make Chloe an actor. Nice. I love this part. Honestly, so fun.
By accident, most strange, bountiful fortune hath mine enemies brought to the shore. Here, cease more questions. Thou art inclined to sleep. 'Tis a good dullness, and give it way. I know thou canst not choose. Come away, servant. Come.
Oh, shit. I'm on.
That's you.
I am ready now.
Get up there.
Approach, my Ariel. Come.
Damn it. No problem. I've got this. I just walk to Rachel and say my line.
Say my line. This is the only reason I know anything about Shakespeare and the Tempest. The only thing, literally. But, let's look at her first.
Rachel looks way too pleased with herself for getting me into this.
I've never done that before, this Quali. She's so raging. Anyway, let's act.
All hail, great mistress. I come to answer thy best pleasure.
Most fearless, generous spirit. Hast thou performed to point the tempest that I bade thee?
Oh, I almost forgot what to do there. I boarded the king's ship.
I boarded the king's ship. In every cabin, I flamed amazement. The fire and cracks of sulfurous roaring, the most mighty Neptune seemed to besiege and make his bold waves tremble.
My brave spirit, who was so firm, so constant, that this coil would not infect his reason?
Not a soul. The king's son, Ferdinand, was the first man that leaped from his ship and cried,
"Hell is empty, and all the devils are here."
Cried, "Hell is empty, and all the devils are here."
Yes! But are they, Ariel, safe?
All right.
I don't know.
I guess this is when I'm supposed to walk somewhere.
The lady in the white dress! What do you mean? Why are you here, lady? I'm quite sure you're not supposed to see her, no? Okay, I'm at my part. Chloe, stand here. Okay.
Not a hair perished, and as thou battest me, I have dispersed them about the isle.
In troops. And loops.
In troops.
Bravo.
Thank you.
Ariel, thy charge exactly is performed, but there's more work.
More toil, more lands. Toil, of course.
Is there more toil? Let me remember thee what thou hast promised.
How now? What is't thou canst demand?
This is about to get real, guys. Just you wait. My liberty.
My liberty.
Indeed.
Thy liberty? Nay, this most of all I will not grant.
That's not her line, is it?
Uh-uh.
What's going on?
Improv, boys. She's went off script. But thou hast promised.
But thou assured my freedom. Didn't thou?
Didn't
I never said how dearly I hold thee.
Oh.
My habit's been to keep my soul well draped. Most loyal spirit, companion, and friend. Is acting in my service not replete with excitement, amusement, and delight?
Of course, mistress.
Aww.
Most truly, it is so.
Mr. Keat, they're way off script. It's magical.
Then why, I pray you, wish you to be free?
Oh, I'm gonna pick excitement with Grold, because it's really emotional, guys.
Excitement ages quickly. And I fear if we set out in search of new, fun, you'll tire of me. And, then I'll be alone.
Oh.
I have thee in my grasp. I will not bend. I will not see thee flying forth alone. The envy would be more than I could bear.
So come with me.
So come with me. Is that not in thy power?
Spirit, take my hands. Most faithful friend.
No.
For but a little longer, I beseech. Continue in thy service to my schemes. And when they are complete, I swear to thee, we shall fly beyond this isle. The corners of the world are mere prologue. I'll seek to make thy happiness so great that in the name of liberties forgot. Aww. What sayest thou to my most hopeful wish?
Say you've just broke my heart.
Say yes!
Yes, aww. I am most pleased.
Your duty done for now, so go forth hence with haste.
I've work to do.
What ho!
You crushed it. So good.
You're a born thespian, my dear. I'll be chasing you down next year. And the ending, absolutely transformative. I am humbled.
You're welcome.
Thanks.
What the hell just happened?
The strangeness of
was
your
that
story.
Real?
Yes.
Heaviness in me.
They
shake
went
it off.
Script.
Come on. We'll visit Caliban, my slave.
Tis a villain, sir. I do not love to look on.
He does make our fire, fetch in our wood. What ho! Slave! Caliban! Come forth, I say!
On!
Come on, twig hair.
As wicked do as e'er my mother brushed.
Thou poisonous slave, got by the devil himself. Filth as thou art, I have lodged thee in mine own cell, till thou didst seek to violate the honor of my child.
Shit.
He's crying.
Fetch us in fuel, and be quick. So, slave, hence.
Fuck you.
Chloe and Rachel done way better.
Where should this music be? In the air or the earth?
Oh, thank God.
This play is super intense.
What is it? A spirit? It carries a brave form, but it is a spirit.
No, wench. It eats and sleeps and hath such senses as we have.
I will resist wench. Such entertainment.
Put thy sword up, traitor!
Do you love me?
Oh heaven, oh earth, bear witness to this sound. I, beyond all limit of what else in the world, do love, prize, honor you.
His tears run down his beard like winter's drops from eaves of reeds.
Go release them, Ariel. My charms I'll break. Their senses I'll restore, and they shall be themselves. Now my charms are all overthrown, and what strength I have's mine own. Pray, release me from my bands, with the help of your good hands.
Wow!
I can't whistle. What a play, guys. The Tempest. Well done, everyone. Including, maybe most importantly, Chloe. Kidding, you're done great jobs. I actually would have liked to have seen the whole play. It would have been fun. So what did you think, guys? Did you absolutely love Chloe's part? Because I know I did. And they promised to run away together. That's what that was. Get out there, Chloe. Rachel's like, bitch, you're coming.
Wasn't that fun?
You're so dead.
Yeah? How dead?
Hella dead.
Aw. Cute. I thought Chloe could fit into her costume. Why is there two costumes? Or was it like a backup costume? I already saw you. What are you doing here, strange lady? Sarah? Hmm? Punk? Yeah, you walk away.
If you don't mean this, It's just making me feel like shit that this life you're describing isn't going to happen.
For fuck's sake! I've never been more serious in my life.
Chloe, we just need to make it through dinner.
I'd be lying if I said I didn't have concerns about your friendship.
I believe that we should look closely at everyone, especially the people in power, to see what secrets they're hiding.
I can't sit here and listen to this bullshit anymore.
Rachel!
Stop it, Dad!
That's enough! You are not welcome here or around my daughter any longer.
Chloe, what would it take to convince you?
I know exactly what kind of person you are from the moment I saw you, and I let my wife's compassion get the better of you.
Oh? What kind of person is
a
that?
A delinquent. A broken girl from a broken home.
Why can't you just tell me the fucking truth?